I started using Premiere Pro about 15 years ago, and I've seen it go through some amazing changes and updates. The feature set in Premiere Pro today is amazing. Apart from just a few features, I can't imagine what else that I need in a professional editing program. However, and that's a big however, the one thing that is always giving me a ton of stress is the stability of the program. Ever since that we've been starting to work on larger projects where we use more than two video tracks, the program starts to act funny. Random crashes, sudden slow playback in a timeline, or just weird stuff like your program monitor going black as you try to create a mask. But the most spectacular thing Premiere did to us is probably corrupting projects. A sudden crash would appear while editing. You restart the program and open up your project, but before you can even see something in your program monitor, Premiere crashes again. And with about 8 available computers here in the office, that project would crash on every single machine upon opening. The only workaround is to create a new project and a new sequence in there, then import the corrupted one, which only sometimes work, by the way, then copy everything from one timeline over to the other, and if that doesn't work, you can try to import the corrupted project into Media Encoder and just hope that you're able to export everything and use that exported video to further edit with in a new project. For years, I've been begging Adobe to work on stability of their program. We've been editing in the 2019 version and refused to update as things only got worse. Yes, we try out every new version, but it feels like it gets worse with every new update. Until a recent new update to the 2020 came out, which is build number 14.2, and I read their release notes that they have finally improved playback, rendering speeds and stability. For once, they came out with a feature that was actually useful. So, carefully, I update and try to edit a few projects with it. And surprisingly, it has been going pretty good so far. The crashes or the sudden slow performance is not gone, but it's definitely less. We did some tests where we had the same clip in Red Raw, Apple ProRes and H264 in a timeline. Now when pressing play, it takes some time until the clips actually start to play. And here's a comparison between version 2019 and 2020, and the amount of frames it takes between pressing the spacebar and actually playback. Basically, nothing improved. We even noticed that the Red Raw took a little longer to start on the 2020 version. And by the way, all files are stored on a local SSD. Now, during playback, we didn't have choppy frames, except for the Red Raw footage. In both versions, they were choppy. Our drive speed was around 100 megabytes per second, which should be perfectly fine, and no reason to have choppy playback. So that proves again that Premiere still relies a lot on the CPU, even with their Mercury timeline. And I don't feel any improvements here, but I do think that a lot of improvement is possible, and I wonder how much resources the GPU is actually being used. Anyways, we did one last playback test with a color grading applied to all the clips. Here we did saw a slight improvement in playback speed. In the next test, we rendered out that same clip to H264, first in 2019 and then in 2020. Now in the new version, we get hardware encoding, which is a new feature. It will utilize your computer's hardware, such as the GPU, more so that rendering will go faster. And some claim it'll go 30 times faster, but when I select the hardware encoding, I get this message. Apparently my system is not compatible. Now in all of our systems here in the office, we have the latest NVIDIA RTX 2080 Ti and one of the flagship's Intel i9 CPUs. So I wonder, do I need to upgrade to a mainframe like NASA has in order to be compatible? No, of course not. We're talking about Premiere, so it's probably a bug or a limitation somewhere. After some fumbling around in the settings, we found out that you're only able to export to a 4K resolution maximum and that your bitrate needs to be set at VBR 1-pass. 2-pass doesn't work. Now, oddly enough, on one of the computers here in the office, we weren't able to get hardware encoding at all. It does have the normal RTX 2080 card, which still is a beast of a card to my eyes, so I have no idea why Premiere doesn't let me hardware encode with it. Anyways, the export was indeed a ton faster. where the 2020 version did the export about double as fast over different formats we exported to. It's not 30 times faster, like some people claim, but that might be because we're just exporting a single clip. Now, when exporting to Apple ProRes, we didn't find the option to use hardware encoding, so the export time was about the same. But let's get to a real test now. Here's a project of an actual YouTube episode where we have a bunch of layers, nested sequences, text, After Effects, pre-comps, and more. So, like before, we first exported that throughout the 19 version and then did an export through the 2020 version. And we had about a 60% speed increasement in 2020. So that's not even double the speed, let alone 30 times, but it is a big improvement, so I'm very happy. Thank you, Adobe. Now, in no means these tests are scientifically correct. There are always factors like memory caching or other influences that make these numbers not 100% correct, but it does give you an idea. So, build number 14.2 is definitely a push in the right direction. Stability is the most important to me and it feels like it has been improved. But Adobe, if you're watching, again, you're going in the right direction. Please keep following that path. You're not at the destination yet. All right, furthermore, we also get ProRes RAW support now. Finally, their auto reframe has been approved. We've never used that, but I'm sure that some people are very happy with that. Next is the ability to add shortcuts to label colors. Now, this one is very interesting to us, as we sometimes work with four people on the same project. Organization and labeling is very important. So this will save us a ton of time. Thank you, Adobe, I really appreciate this option. And finally is a filter for your animations in the effects controls to show only those properties that you've edited or animated. Animating Beziers should also be easier, although I don't see any difference there, but that could also be me, I don't know. So these are the new features of 2020 and my frustrations. Now, don't get me wrong, guys, I love Premiere, but it's one of those like love-hate relationships. You can't live with it, but you also can't live without. Anyways, let me know in the comments, guys, how does the new update work out for you? Is it more stable? Do you see a better improvement? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, stay creative.
As the video file...
Hey, mom.
Now it will not automatically play the subtitles, and that is because VLC cannot locate those subtitles files, and that is because they...
Dave!